Welcome back everyone, and this is the video on how to extract data and how to find poolable outcomes in your articles from secondary screening. So we've got the article of Krupp right here, Robert Krupp, and we've got the article of Richard B. Lipton right here. These two were the ones which were possible to extract. So I'm gonna show you how to assess if the outcomes can be assessed, extracted or not. For example, in this article that we had, this one was not a proper clinical trial. If I can show you, actually just use the DY. As you can see, it's a phase 1-2 group pharmacokinetic study. So it's actually a phase 1 clinical trial. And I'm just going to show you why we would not be willing to include it right now. Okay. So now this is the sheet. You have to make a Google sheet. I would recommend using Google sheet because you can collaborate with different people on it. I mean, it's just an online sheet and lots of people can edit it. I'm not sure you can do it on Excel. Moreover, the Google Sheet is easy to use. So, in my opinion, I think it's the best option. So, what you're going to do is, first of all, the study's name is Krupp. You always use the last name of the author. We're going to click on Krupp, the year it was published, which was, I think, 2022. It was published in 2022. Then we're going to click on 2022. And then we're going to just copy the URL or DY, it's up to you. I always prefer the URL or, just the way to which article can be accessed quickly. Then it's a randomized dose ranging placebo controlled phase 2-3 trial. So it's a randomized controlled trial. If you go towards the full text, you will just, double blind randomized placebo controlled trial. So it's a randomized controlled trial, RCT. This RCT is like one of the highest forms of, studies that we can do. The intervention would be our zivagipant, and they would have also mentioned the dose of 5, 10, and 20. So we're going to mention it as 5, 10, and 20 milligrams. It's always better to have as much info as you can. The comparator was placebo, and now the outcomes. This is the most important part. We're going to click on outcomes. Now, how are you going to find outcomes? Also, you can also copy the NCT number and add a separate column for NCT number as well. But I don't do that usually, so it's up to you. Now, we're going to go to treatments and outcomes. So, outcomes of efficacy. As we can see that the outcome of efficacy was pain, freedom, and freedom from MBS. MBS would be the most bothersome symptom. We're going to control C. We're going to click here. We're going to copy it. Okay, then we're going to click on Alt plus Enter. And we're going to click in twice so that we can add a bit of space between it. Then we have got the secondary efficacy outcomes. And then we're going to copy these. I mean, these are lots, so we're just going to copy at least 4 or 5, here. That's it. I think these would be enough. Then we're going to copy these. And after each outcome, click Alt plus Enter. It's always better to have each outcome in a, single line because it makes the sheet way more clean and easy to study. As we can see, like, these are all the outcomes of efficacy. I forgot to write efficacy here. So these are the outcomes of efficacy, and we can easily see that the primary outcome were the two shown above and the secondary outcomes are the ones shown below. Now we're gonna click on outcomes safety. There are basically two main types of outcomes: the outcomes of efficacy and outcomes of safety. The outcomes of efficacy would include anything that can show how well the drug is acting. The outcomes of safety would include how much safe the drug is. So for safety, we include AEs, which would be adverse effects, serious AEs, serious adverse effects, and clinical lab evaluations, etc. So, for the sake of this study, we're just gonna include all these three, and we're gonna once again use Alt plus Enter to separate them. As we can see, I've just extracted data from this one study. Now I'm gonna extract data from the Lipton as well. And once again, easy to do each and everything. Lipton 2023, I believe. Yes, 2023. Then we're gonna control C. Now, this article is paid. So if you have a PDF of this article, it's always better that you post a link to the PDF. Like, you know, upload the PDF in Drive and control, you know, copy the link, control C the link right here. Also, on a side note, I made this whole folder for these video series, and you can find the relative documents of each video here. For example, this one, Prisma template was shown in this one, so I've shown it right here. Then this one had all the PCOS table of our study. In this one, I showed about the Prisma flowchart. So as you can see, I've like mentioned all of these templates right here. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead. The design, once again, RCT. If you don't believe me, you can double-blind, randomized, placebo-controlled, multi-center phase 3 trial. So that's it. It's, some people also write if it's a phase 2 or phase 3 here. I don't, because it's not necessary. We will write it in the baseline characteristics, but not this one. So yeah, no need to write this one, in my opinion. Then we're going to see if we can find the dose in the abstract. I don't believe we can. Yeah, 10 mg. There we go. So it was only zivegepant. 10 mg. We're just going to click on 10 mg here. Okay. Then placebo. And once again, the outcomes of efficacy. The co-primary endpoint, once again, freedom from pain, pain from MBS. These are the outcomes of efficacy. And when they haven't mentioned the secondary outcomes, but I can assure you, like, they were the same as compared to this one. So we're just going to copy those right here as well. And then the adverse effects and serious adverse effect as the safety outcome. Safety, they did not mention it right here. So you know what I'm going to do is I'm going to open the NCT. It's also another way of finding the results. If you can't find the whole text, you know, just click on results posted in the clinicaltrials.gov website, and then you're going to see all of the results. Truly adverse effects. As you can see, we have all the adverse effects, all cause mortality, adverse events, non-serious adverse events, etc. So yeah, same as all this. Now we're going to move to our third trial. And this one was actually by Bhardwaj. And it was written in 2024. So this one was not available when we did. I mean, it's July 24th. Yeah, we completed the article before July, so it was not available at the time of our article, you know. Then we're gonna control C, post its link here. It was a phase 1 open label single dose pharmacokinetics. So we're gonna click here and we're gonna write phase 1 clinical trials. It was not an RCT, so we're just gonna click on phase 1 clinical trial. And just to be safe, we're gonna just click on open label. So open label means that there was no blinding. Okay, so there was no sort of randomization or no blinding. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna see the intervention. Intranasal 10 mg dose. Once again, Zivegi 10 mg. Comparison would be with placebo. And now we're going to see the outcomes. Now, see, this is a phase 1 trial. A phase 1 trial is a pharmacokinetic study. So I'm 90% sure that the outcomes of this study would be different. But just to be on the safe side, we're going to see. Once again, the safety is done by adverse events. And yeah, just the adverse events. The primary endpoint was Cmax, TCmax, KE, and T1 by 2, and area under curve and all that. So these were the primary endpoints. We're gonna control V them here. And once again, we're gonna use Alt plus Enter to separate each and every single one of them. Now, as you can see that these outcomes are not poolable, right? So in my opinion, we should not include it. You're gonna obviously debate that adverse effects is written here, so we can include it because adverse effects written here. But I wouldn't recommend it. Why? Because the main outcome is not usually adverse effects or outcome of safety. It is not our main outcome most of the time. The main outcome in this study was a pain from freedom, right? And the freedom from most bothersome symptom. So if we start looking at the adverse effects and the number of adverse effects, we're going to get more trials as well, but they wouldn't be as strong. So personally, once again, it's a matter of choice of excluding this one. It's not necessary to include, neither is it necessary to exclude. But I would personally recommend excluding them. So that's why we're going to select this row. We're going to paint it a bit red, and we're going to go, and we're going to exclude the Bhardwaj study with the reason that it does not have the outcomes that we need. So that's how we exclude studies on the basis of wrong outcomes. And just for the sake of this video, I'm gonna include two more studies, one with the name of Faizan and one with the name of Shehzad. And I'm just gonna say that all of these studies have the same outcome, so that it's easy for me to explain all of this to you. Okay. Now these two studies are just fictional and just for example. Yeah, there we go. Now we have included all these studies. So for this so-called example, we are including four studies right here. And since 19 studies were excluded, the total number of excluded studies would be 15. Now obviously you're gonna have to mention all of these reasons right here, and then you're gonna mention how each and every article was excluded. But this is how we do the preliminary screening, and in the next video I'm gonna show you how we can do data extraction from these articles. Okay, so it's goodbye for now, and I hope that this video proved helpful. Thank you so much.